with a recap of the story, The Making of a Scientist. The law we have read that Bright, who was nicknamed as Richie by his mother, he was a very curious child from the beginning itself. He had that zest for learning. He used to like learning work that his mother used to give him every time. He was a bright student and he was very regular in his daily tasks. By the time he was in second class, he had collected 25 species of butterflies which were found around his neighborhood. And it was at that time that his mother gave him a book by the name of The Travels of Monarch 10. The book told how the monarch butterflies migrated to Central America, which was the turning point for Bright as it turned his curiosity towards science. Let's continue further. Please continue from the stanza at the end of the children's book.
At the end of the children's book that his mother had got him, the readers of the book were invited to help the study of butterfly migrations. They were asked to tag butterflies by Dr. Frederick, a bureaucrat of the University of Toronto in Canada. Richie's mother wrote to the doctor and soon he was attaching adhesive tags to the wings of the butterflies. The person who would find a butterfly with a tag was asked to send the tag to Dr. Bureaucrat. The butterfly collecting season lasted for around 6 weeks. Then Ebright understood that if he kept on collecting butterflies one by one, he would not be able to collect it many. So the next step he took was that he decided to raise a flock of butterflies in his basement. He used to catch a female butterfly, collect its egg, and raise them in his basement through their proper life cycle. Then he used to tag the wings of the butterflies and would let them go. There were thousands of monarchs in his basement growing in different life stages for many years. Soon he started losing interest in tagging butterflies as it was a very slow and tiring process. It also did not get him much response. He said that out of the many butterflies that he tagged, only two could be recaptured by people, and those two were not more than 75 miles away from where he lived. Then okay. In the seventh grade...
Wait. So the stanza, we understand that after he got that book from his mother, he started doing more research work on butterflies. He started collecting butterflies. He started tagging them. And he wrote to Dr. Frederick A. Bureaucrat of the University of Toronto in Canada. And he sent invitations to people that whosoever got butterfly, they could tag it and send it to Dr. Bureaucrat. Butterfly collecting season lasted for around 6 weeks. But Bright understood very well that it was a very monotonous job and he would not be able to gather much information by doing so. So he decided that he would be raising butterflies in his own house in the basement. He raised a lot of butterflies and he raised them in their proper life cycles for several years. Now, there were thousands of monarchs in his basement and at different stages. But he started losing interest in tagging butterflies. As I told you, it was a very monotonous process. It didn't get him much response also. So he said that out of the many butterflies that he tagged, only two could be recaptured by people. And those two were not more than 75 miles away from where he lived. So that didn't give him actually a very good response. Let's continue further. We'll come to the question of this. Okay. Please continue. When he was in seventh class.
When he was in seventh class, he came to know what real science was as he lost at a county science fair. It was a really sad feeling for him to see all other people win something while he did not win anything. He showed frog tissue slides under a microscope, but realized that all the winners had actually tried to perform an experiment and not just make a neat display out of their projects. He had already started developing the competitive spirit inside him. Now he had decided that he would be making a real project for the next year's fair. He thought and realized that he had maximum knowledge about the subject of insects, as he had been studying them for quite some time now. He wrote to the Dr. Bureaucrat for ideas and he sent back a lot of ideas for his next year's project. He remained busy with those ideas all throughout his high school and won many prizes. In his eighth class, he tried to find the cause of a viral disease that killed nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Ebright thought that the disease was being transmitted through beetles, so he started raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. It was of no use, but when he showed that he had tried such an experiment, he won something for his project. For the next year, he tried the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarchs. He put forward the theory that viceroy butterflies looks like monarch because monarch do not taste good to the birds and birds like to eat viceroys. So the more the viceroy looked like the monarch, the less likely it is that viceroy would be eaten by a bird. He wanted to show in his project that would a bird eat monarch or not. He found out that the sterling bird would prefer eating a monarch. Later research showed that the viceroy copied the monarch. This project won him the first division in the zoology department and the third overall position in the county science fair.
Okay, so when he was in his seventh grade, he lost one of the county science fair. He was not able to win it. He was very depressed in the beginning, actually, but then he realized that in that fair, he did not win anything because he didn't reveal out anything new. Science experiments are nothing. It's not about just showing something. It's about, you know, coming up with new ideas, revealing the truth, which is hidden yet. So nothing new was there taken out, right? So after that, throughout the year, he was busy thinking about what to do and what next he should present in the county fair next year, which would win him a position, right? So he showed frog tissues and the slides and microscope in the first one. We are talking about the first one, which he lost, but realized that all the winners had actually tried to perform an experiment and not just a neat display of their projects. So the next year's fair, when he was preparing for that, he realized that he had maximum knowledge about the subject of insects, especially about butterflies. So he wrote to Dr. Urquhart again and sent him a lot of, Urquhart replied back with a lot of ideas for the next year's project. So Dr. Urquhart was always supporting him a lot because this curious child was sending him, writing him letters first for the tagging the butterflies, by coming to know more about butterfly species. And now he was working on his project for the county fair the next year. He remained busy with those ideas all throughout his high school and won many prizes. So he won many prizes based upon the recommendations and the suggestions which Dr. Urquhart had given him. So when he was in his 8th class, he tried to find the cause of the viral disease that killed nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Monarch caterpillars, young butterflies, they were killed because of this viral disease. That was one thing which he revealed in his county fair. A bright throw up. Ebright thought that the disease was being transmitted through beetles, so he tried to raise the beetles along with the caterpillars in the basement, but then didn't got any response from that. I mean, it didn't impact them at all. So it was clear that it was not because of beetles. For the next year, he tried the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarchs. So these are the species of butterflies he's talking about, and he says that viceroy butterflies, they imitate monarch butterflies. He put forward the theory that viceroy butterflies look like monarchs, right? Viceroy look like monarchs, so they also behave like monarchs because monarchs taste good to the birds. So more the viceroy look like monarch, less likely it is that the viceroy would be eaten by a bird. So monarchs do not taste good to the birds. Monarch the birds didn't like monarchs. Birds liked viceroys. So viceroys behave like monarchs in order to save themselves from the bird. So this was something which he proved in his project, that would a bird eat monarchs or not. So he found out that the sterling bird would prefer eating a monarch. And later research showed that viceroys copied the monarchs. So this project won him the first division in the zoology department and the third overall position in the county science fair. So he won the third position in the science fair. Just give me a pause for a second.
During his second year of high school, Richard started a research from which he found about an unknown insect hormone that later helped him in his new theory about the life of cells as well. The question from where the research started was very simple as to what was the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa. Most of the people said that the spots were made for looking for making it look more decorative, but Dr. Urquhart did not believe in what others said. To find the answer to this question, E. Bright and other excellent science students together made a device that proved that these spots produced a hormone necessary for the full development of a butterfly from a pupa. With this, E. Bright won the first prize at the county and engineering fair. His project won third prize for zoology. He also got a chance to work at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. He continued his work with the monarch pupa as a high school junior, and that led him to win the first prize at the International Science Fair. After winning this prize, he also got a chance to work at the Army laboratory during summers. Then during his senior year, he tried another experiment in which he grew cells from a monarch's wing in a culture and showed that cells would divide and develop into a normal butterfly wing scales, provided that they were treated with the hormone from the gold spots. This research of his won the first prize at the International Fair, and he spent the summer after graduation doing more research on the subject at the Army Laboratory and the Laboratory of US Department of Agriculture. Then he worked some more on the hormone released from the gold spot during the following summer at the Laboratory of the Agriculture Department. He identified the chemical structure of the hormone using the lab special equipment. After 1.5 years, E. Bright got the idea for his new theory, which was about the cell life. The idea came to him when he was looking at the X-ray photos of the chemical structure of the hormone. He did not get excited about his discovery as soon as he found it, but came to a realization that his years of study on the insect hormone had solved one of the puzzles of biology. It had solved the mystery of how cells read the blueprint of its DNA. He found that as the DNA is in the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity, therefore it determines the form and function of a cell. Hence, DNA is the blueprint of life.
Okay. This stanza further talks about his achievements. So when he was in his second year of high school, he researched about an unknown insect hormone that helped him in his new theory about the fossils. Now his discoveries shifted from butterflies and insects to the functioning of the cells. The question from where the research started was very simple as to what was the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa. Again, the beginning of the functioning of the cells also started from the purpose of the gold spots. Monarch pupa had some gold spots. So it was like the question was that what are the purpose? Why? What is the functioning of these golden spots? So people in the beginning believed that it was just to make them decorative. It was given by God to make them more beautiful. But Dr. Urquhart did not believe in that, what the people said. So Bright and another excellent science student, he together made a device to prove that the spots produced a hormone which were necessary for the development of the butterfly from a pupa. Right? So again, this discovery made him win the first prize at the county science fair and his entry engineering fair. So throughout the school, his curiosity, his experimentation, his investigation related to butterflies, insects, and other things helped him to move a step further. Now, this was the time when he won the county science fair and entry to the international science engineering fair. This was this his project won third prize for zoology too. So this was a big chance for A Bright, because he got a chance to work at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So Walter Reed Army Institute of Research, he was working there. In the National winning this prize, he got a chance to work with the Army Laboratory. Now, then during his senior year, tried another experiment where he shifted his experimentation from butterflies to the growing of the cells from a monarch's wing in a culture. And he showed that cells would divide and develop into a normal butterfly wing scales, provided that they were treated with a hormone from the gold spots. Okay, so we learned about all this, and finally he was there in the Army laboratory where he got a chance to learn more about it. He identified the chemical structure of the hormone, and Bright got the idea of his new theory now, which was about the cell life and about the functioning of cells. light came to him when he was at the X-ray photo of the chemical structure of the hormone. He did not get excited about his discovery. So found it relaxed. His expectation from insects, butterflies. But then he came on to the functioning of the cells, which was a big question in biology. So he found that as a DNA is the nucleus of a cell that controls heredity, we all know that. So therefore, it determines the form and function of a cell. Since DNA is the blueprint of life, this was again something which was given by Richard Wright. And from starting from butterflies, insects, and coming onto the functioning of a cell, winning several county fairs, zoology department, he won many prizes, and then entering into the international science fair, then coming into, getting a chance to work with an army laboratory, it was a big victory for him. I think we are just left with the last section that we are going to continue tomorrow. Is it clear till this point?